Grand Rising, good people. Today is Friday, December the 7th. We are more than 50% of the way there. This is day 3 of a soft drive fast. It was supposed to be my last day yesterday, but I feel like I could do another day. We shouldn't be afraid to test the limits of our body. God created our body super strong and super powerful. And just being able to go without food and drinking water for 3 days is amazing to me. So God gave me this body and I'm going to test it another day. But this definitely will be my last day of a soft dry fast regardless. The most I've done before this was 2 days. So let's see where we're at on the scale today. Yeah, it's your boy, The Journey to Excel. Friday, December 7th. We almost halfway there, folks. When I started this fast, I didn't plan to do 3 days of a soft dry fast. Yo! I only wanted to do 2 days soft dry fasted. And, well, I was going to be 3 days soft dry fasted, but not 3 days straight. The plan was to go two water, two soft dry, back to two water, then a day of soft dry, and then finish the fast with a day of water. But, you know, I did my 2 days soft dry fast and, you know, I wanted to test my body, push it to the limit. I feel like God created us with strong bodies. God created man in his image. And he blessed us with bodies that were built to withstand a lot. So after day two, I was feeling okay. So I decided to push it to day three. So here we are, day three. Yesterday I was feeling drained sometimes, like I didn't have any energy. I also got lightheaded when I stood up quickly, but that went just as fast as it came. I got hungry at times, but not as sharp as the hunger pains as I get when I'm water fasting. Oh, you see the Christmas trolley? But yeah. It wasn't anything too difficult, you know. Philippians 4:13 in the Bible says, I can do all through God which strengthens me. Now, the way I apply that to my life is I could go through any test. I could have money in my pocket, or I could be broke. I could have food on my stomach, or I could be hungry. I could do anything that I pray about and set my mind to once I ask God to help me. You know, I got a lot going on in my life right now, but I'm gonna push through it because God gives me strength. Another thing that I went through yesterday, I couldn't fall asleep last night. It was very difficult for me to get some rest. I don't know if it's because I have a lot on my mind or if it's because, you know, they say once you're fasting for a few, you start getting insomnia a little bit. It's hard to fall asleep. You have a lot of energy. But anyway, it's not anything I've been going through so far that's making me want to break this fast. I feel like this has been a relatively simple fast. Yeah, I have been going through some detox symptoms, but the most important thing is my mind has been focused on withstanding 8 days of this fast. I could probably do another soft dry fast if I wanted to, but the boy getting a little thirsty, I ain't gonna hold you. So I'm gonna just stop the soft dry fast today at 3 days, and I'm just finish the rest of this 8 days of my fasting doing a water fast. So that's where we at on day 5. more than halfway there. The boy's still losing weight. Oh yes, I'm definitely under 300 pounds, 299.1 or something like that today. It'll be even less than that tomorrow. And then once we start drinking water, it's going to go back up. Hopefully not back to 300, but you know, if I do, I do. I know how to get this weight off of me. And once I break my fast, I'll be eating some alkaline fruits. So my weight should pretty much stay where I stopped my fast at. But we'll see, man. Journey to Excel continues. Keep grinding, keep pushing. Prayer rising, good people. Today is Saturday, December 8th, day 6, end of my 3-day dry fast. Finally get to have some of this. Now I'm thirsty as I feel, like just down in the whole thing. Breaking a dry fast, you have to be careful. You have to sip the water gradually. Ease the water back into your body. Get your body back acclimated to drinking again. So I'm going to take my time sipping this water throughout the day. And I'm going to get back into a water fast today on day 6. But let's see where we are on the scale. Peace, good people. We're on day 6. Finished my 3-day water fast yesterday. It was a little rough, you know, but I feel like God built our bodies to be strong, like I said yesterday. And I was able to push through everything that I went through. Got some cramps, but they didn't last long. They came and they went. I was extremely thirsty, which showed me that I was probably dehydrated. I didn't have any energy. I felt like I had to push myself through, but I made it. You know, I'm not dead. I'm still here on day 6. A couple of days left for the fast, and I'll be completing my 8 days, but I made it through. You got to live and learn from your mistakes, and that's what I did. You know, I feel like I shouldn't have did 2 days water and then 3 days dry. What I should have did is maybe 3 days of water and 2 days dry. Your dry fast days should definitely be less than your water fast days. Did I say that right? Yes. Your dry fast days should be less than your water fast days. So I should have maybe did 4 water, 3 dry, something like that. But you know, you live and you learn. I'm not perfect. I'm just a obese, unhealthy person that realizes the error in my ways, and I'm trying to do better and reverse the things that I've done. So it's a process. It's a journey. So some of the things I experienced, like I said, I had the dry mouth. I had fatigue, some cramps. I was lightheaded at times, but I still was able to complete my 10,000 steps. I still was able to do everything I wanted to do. Like, this is a process. I'm learning, I'm researching, and you know, I'm trying to be a better person, a better man. I'm trying to be a healthy version of myself. So there we are, day 6. The journey to Excel continues. Keep grinding and keep pushing. Grand Rising, good people. Sunday, December 9th. Day 7. We're almost there. Almost there. So let's see where we at on day 7 on a scale after rehydrating from the dry fast. Two 96.7. Yeah, this your boy, The Journey to Excel. We on day 7. The finish line is so close right now. Sunday, December 9th. Yesterday was real rough for your boy. My first day off of the 2 days of the dry fast, rehydrating. My body just felt drained. Like, I didn't have any energy. Even when I started sipping water, I was still thirsty. So I know I overdid it with the 3 days of soft dry fast, and I should have prepared myself better. But you know, you live and you learn. I pushed through, I still made it. I'm still good, I'm still here. Now, even on the second day of rehydrating, my energy feel like it's down. I ain't gonna hold you, but still committed. Got these today and tomorrow, and I'm done with this 8 days of my fasting, and I'm not quitting. Some people say that you gotta listen to your body. Well, I feel like my body is strong enough to push through these last 2 days and the detox symptoms that I'm going through. So that's what I'm going to do. Other than that, like, yesterday wasn't too crazy. I didn't really feel like myself from the time I broke my fast at 6 in the morning until 4 p.m. I just felt out of it. But, you know, it wasn't too crazy. I pushed through, got through my work day, made it home, went to bed, got some rest, and I'm back up and back at it. No other problems other than my energy was came and went. Hunger pains came strongly when I started drinking the water. As when I do the dry fast, the hunger pains are either not there or they're not as intense. Also, I had some slight cramping, but it came and it went, and a little bit of dizziness when I, you know, stood up quickly or whatever. But it wasn't anything too crazy. So we just, like I've been saying, you can't be afraid to test the limits of your body. So we're on day 7, about to start work. Everybody have a good day. Keep grinding, keep pushing. The Journey to Excel continues. Grand rising, good people. This your boy, The Journey to Excel. Monday, December 10th. One more day. This is the last day. We'll be officially finished 8 days of fasting tonight at 11 something. But we're going to push through one more day. Let's see where we are on the scale. What up? It's your boy, The Journey to Excel. On the 8th day, December the 10th, we back, man. Like, this is the first day after this dry fast that I'm feeling 100%, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all the truth. That dry fast likely that got me up out of here. But, you know, I pushed through. Today, I feel like my throat is back. The other days coming off the dry fast, a dry fast causes your throat to lose some of its elasticity. So my throat was contracted a little bit. Felt like I had a sore throat. Had a lot of things going on, but I pushed through. Now, since I've came off my fast 2 days ago, I've gained about 3 point something pounds. I don't like that shit. Like, I like the losing the weight quickly, but that gaining the weight, I don't like that. But, you know, you gotta take the good with the bad, and nothing I could do about it. Yesterday wasn't too bad. I still was feeling lethargic, and I got slight headache, came and went, and a little bit of cramps, but nothing too crazy. Yesterday was an okay day. I just didn't have the energy. Like, I couldn't hit my 10,000 steps that I've done every day of this fast. Yesterday was the only day I haven't done it. But today, the boy woke up feeling great. Like, I was moving early in the morning, like 6 o'clock. I got some steps in, and you know, I got the energy back today, even though today is the last, supposed to be my last day of this fast. I don't even know. I might do another day. But the reason I picked today to break my fast is because I have a test in the morning, and I just wanted to, you know, be in the right state of mind and spirits to be able to perform in my best for this test I have. But, you know, right now I feel like I'm feeling good. If anybody follows the A Healthy Alternative YouTube channel, a lot of good information. You should follow them, subscribe, like, comment, all that. But Chris James, the creator of the channel, speaks about the Goldilocks zone. That's when you've been doing an extended fast and you get to a point where you all good money. Like, you're not hungry, you got energy, like you feeling like you can keep fasting forever. And I feel like today might be my Goldilocks zone day, where I feel like I'm cool. Like, I don't have to stop this fast tonight at 11:53 or whatever time it was started. I could go for another day or two or three or four. Like, I feel great today. Like, my energy is cool. So I may stop it in the morning, I may not. But I do need to get some more fruit. I don't feel like I got enough fruit to break my fast and make some smoothies yet. And I also wanted to infuse my smoothies with a product called CMOS Gold. And we'll get into that once I get it, and I'll tell y'all the benefits of it and all that. Other than that, this is your boy, The Journey to Excel. Keep grinding, keep pushing. Grand rising, good people. Today is Tuesday, December 11th. Fast is over. We made it. It's been a long 8 days. Well, it wasn't that bad. You know, it's time I had to push myself. Thought it was over for the kid. Drive fast, like liable to almost got your boy up out of here. But, you know, I made it through. Here I am on the other side of my 8 days. Just proud of myself. Let's see where we at. Final weigh-in. And I might do another day. Who knows? Anyway, we done day 8. Let's see where we at on the scale. Yeah, good people, what's going on? It's your boy, The Journey to Excel, up here in Newark, Penn Station. About to break this fast. First time I'm eating since last Sunday night. We made it. So, I just wanted to get something simple, some raw, juicy fruits to break my fast with. I have a couple fruit salads, one with just watermelon, another one that has some pineapples and grapes and cucumbers and strawberries and melons in it. You want to start breaking your fast with something that has a lot of juice content in it, a lot of water. So that's where we at. The Journey to Excel continues. Keep grinding, keep pushing. Show y'all what I'm working with. This looks so delicious. Oh my goodness.